of other women say, be my daddy too. Yeah, lots of other women say, be my daddy too. Well, I tell them I don't want no other baby but you.
That was No Other Baby, originally and more popularly done by the Vipers, and then the Beatles did a cover of it in 2000. So very cool. So Wayne, like I said, Paul is your favorite Beatle, and so it's interesting to hear him do covers, because like you said, when the Beatles do covers, Paul isn't normally the one singing them, is he?
That's right, yeah. But when they first started out with the Please Please Me album,
right,
they did some covers.
Yeah.
Even Twist and Shout was a cover.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
But that was good. I liked the sound.
Yeah. So, Duke, I got a question for you. Which do you have a favorite member of the Beatles?
Yeah, Ringo.
Really? Oh, you and I have the same taste then.
He's a drummer, that don't count.
Of course.
Yeah, yeah.
That's right, because you are a drummer, aren't you?
Right.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Very nice. Very cool. So, yeah. So, how'd you like the Beatles rendition of No Other Baby?
That's good.
Yeah. So, very cool. So, next up, going to be, this next one was, another one that was written by Julian and co-written by Mark Spiro. This is the Beatles with I Don't Want to Know. I don't want to know. It was the Beatles with Julian singing lead. So
yeah, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm sorry. I just want to talk to my brother.
Dude, come on.
You know, we've been twins forever. You know.
Well, I would hope so. I hope you didn't just become twins. Yeah.
And for the last 35 years, all of our life, I didn't know that Ringo was your favorite.
Really?
Favorite Beatle. Okay. Yeah.
Well, yeah. Now you learned something new.
Yeah. Well, I should have known because you both play the drums. So. Mm-hmm.
Well, every day is a school day, as they say.
That's right. School is out and all.
Yeah.
But anyways,
well, if you go back to when he got into the group and everything, too, he was the rough guy.
You know, that's true. They were afraid of Ringo before he joined the group because he was older. Mm-hmm. He had a little streak of gray and a beard. And I don't know how anybody could be afraid of him.
I know.
He's like Dobie Gillis, you know. But anyway, they were a little scared. But after they got into the group, he was like...
Right.
The one everybody
wanted. One
of
the guys.
Yeah. Tony's got a famous story about when they were breaking up and Ringo.
That's right. That's right. It's during the White Album, I believe it was.
That's
so
right.
It wasn't when they were breaking up. It was just they were having quite a bit of difficulties with each other, and it got to the point where they could barely be in the same room with each other.
Mm-hmm.
And Ringo was just like feeling really sort of left out. And I love this story because he always tells this story when he's going to play Octopus's Garden.
Uh-huh.
And. This is what led to him writing Octopus's. This is what led to the event that led to him writing Octopus's Garden. He went over to John and he was like, you know, I just feel like you three are all really close, and I'm just kind of out the picture. And John's like, oh, that's a relief. I thought it was you three. And then, so he goes over to Paul and he says, you know, I just kind of feel like you and John and George are all really close, and I'm just kind of out the picture. And Paul's like, I thought it was you three. And then he does the same to George. I feel like you and John and Paul, the three of you, were all really close. You know, I mean, I just sort of feel like I'm out of the picture. I thought it was you three.
They all thought
wild.
The same.
Yeah, and so then Ringo was like, I'm going on holiday. And so he went away for a couple of weeks and went on a fishing boat. And he was having lunch, and it was fish and chips, but the you know, the french fries were normal. The fish looked kind of weird though, and so he asked the captain, what's this? And he's like, oh, that's octopus. And so he ended up talking to the captain about octopus and how they hide the stuff in caves. And so, and then he'd come home and he wrote Octopus's Garden.
Yeah,
it's very cool.
It's a great story.
It is.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that last one though was by Julian, and it was I Don't Want to Know. So guys, how'd you like that?
I liked it. It had a good beat to it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I think he sounds a lot more like John on this one than he did on the last one that we played. Yeah. So, Wayne, what do you think?
You know, we've talked about this before, you and I.
Yeah.
I don't know why Julian...
it wasn't as popular in the Beatles as his father.
Yeah. When all is said and done, the stuff that he sang and that he came out with is really good music.
It really is.
And so I don't know why they didn't showcase him more.
That's what I mean, like, because he's not as popular as John, and I think that it is because he's got different ideas and a different sound to his father, and at that time it was only... John died in 1980, and Julian only joined in 84, and so 4 years later, you know, I don't think people were ready yet, you know? Even though the three of them and Julian were ready, everyone else wasn't, I don't think.
But so. I like what he's done.
Oh, yeah. Same here. So, Right. Well, next up, we've got a song by Ringo. It's, let's see, one sec, I have it right here. It's actually written, he found this in a box someplace, because it was written by John, actually. Oh. And so he dug it out of a box someplace, and it'd been, it'd been 20 years since John had passed away, you know? And so he decided that, you know, to commemorate 20 years since John's death, that he would finally record this song that John had written 20 plus years ago. And so this is the Beatles doing Goodnight Vienna. All right, that was Goodnight Vienna, and that was sung by Ringo. So very cool, you know. So, Wayne, how'd you like that one?
It's good. It's interesting that John wrote the song, and he just found it in a box.
Yeah, well, like I said, and when he found it, he decided that, you know, since it was about 20 years ago, because this was, Any Road was put out in 2000, since it was 20 years ago that that John had passed, then, you know, he decided to put that out there, you know, as a sort of tribute.
Yeah,
you know?
Great tribute to John. That's great. And I know John also wrote "I'm the Greatest" for Ringo.
Right.
So,
yeah, definitely.
All right.
It was very good.
It's I like what's compiled on this album.
Well, thank
it's very
you.
Good.
Thank you. So next up is a song written and sung lead by George Harrison. This is "Wake Up, My Love."